Hi everyone. In previous part we have seen the process of ovulation, and in this part we'll see what are the clinical confirmatory tests that indicates the ovulation. So out of them, the first one is Spinnbarkeit test. So what is happening in this test? Firstly, we'll collect the cervical secretion and by the mean of pipette, and we'll place on the one glass slide, and we'll put the another glass slide over the previous one, and when we'll pull these glass slide away from each other, we'll see the one string is forming in between the two glass slide, that is the mucus fiber string, thread like structure, and that will extend up to 10 cm without any break in between them. That indicate the high estrogen peak at the time of ovulation. What it causes, it makes the cervical secretion to become more clear, thin or more stretchy. So by this we can easily evaluate that the woman is ovulating, because the high estrogen peak causes the elasticity or the stretchability of the mucus fibers. Okay, the another one is the Fern test. So what we'll do in Fern test, again we'll prepare the glass slide, and on the glass slide we'll collect the cervical secretion from a pipette and place it over there, and we'll dry it, and then we'll see under the microscope what will happen. We'll see there are the mucus fiber strings, and on these mucus fibers there are the dried particle of sodium chloride on the mucus fibers. Because the property of estrogen is that it absorbs more water than electrolyte. So at the time of ovulation, as the estrogen level rises, that creates more absorption of water and electrolyte. And at the time, if we collect the specimen and we'll dry it and see under the microscope, we'll see there are the more sodium chloride, more electrolytes, dried particle over the mucus fibers. That will create a ferning pattern, and that ferning pattern indicates the woman is ovulating. And the third one is BBT. So what is BBT? That is basal body temperature. So how we can calculate it? Basal body temperature is the lowest body temperature which can be measured at the time of rest. So firstly, we'll ask a woman that as soon she get up from the bed, don't do perform any activities, don't go anywhere, first check her body temperature. And if her menstrual cycle is regular for about 28 days, and if she perform this test for around 3 to 4 months, then she can easily be calculate that what will be her fertile period. So how can she perform her BBT? She find that if she record graphically, and if she have 28 day normal menstrual cycle, so on day of 14 she will find there is sudden drop in body temperature, because high estrogen declines the body temperature. And before ovulation or in pre ovulatory phase, that is an average body temperature. And as soon she ovulates and the graafian follicles become corpus luteum, that releases the progesterone. That progesterone, which is thermogenic, rises the body temperature, which is about 0.2 to 0.5 degree centigrade, and that remain constant, and it will continue before 2 days of next menstrual cycle. So this is how she can compare that there is a biphasic pattern of body temperature. At the time of ovulation, there is decline in body temperature. Before that is the average body temperature, and after ovulation there is a rise in body temperature. So this biphasic pattern can easily help her to calculate the fertile period. So this is how by these tests we can confirm that woman is ovulating or not. Spinnbarkeit test indicates the stretchability or elasticity of cervical mucous fibers with the increase of high estrogen level, and the Fern test indicates the ferning pattern of cervical mucus because of more absorption of sodium chloride crystals on these dried frame. And the third one is basal body temperature, that indicates the sudden drop at the time of estrogen peak around the ovulation, and after that, after the ovulation, there is sudden rise in the body temperature. So these are the tests which can easily confirm the ovulatory period in a woman. Thank you.